So once your wine is done fermenting, how do you know it's fermented enough? And how do you take it from this mash to wine? Once you take this lid off, you can smell the wine. But how do you get that goodness out of there and into your glass? Well, there's a lot of methods out there, and I'm gonna talk about my methods, which are pretty simplistic, and I'll go through some other methods that a lot of other people use. It's like most things. The more you do it, the more you learn, the better you get. One thing's for sure, there's a lot of ways to do this. When I started doing this, I learned from an old Italian years ago, and I've kind of modified some of those thoughts. It's definitely an art form. You find some things work, some things don't, and don't repeat the things that don't work. Now, when I'm making the wine, I don't use any preservatives. Because of this, I would say that my wine is a little drier than others, not as sweet. Now, there's definitely a process from going from grapes to wine and getting it all cleaned up. We'll now go into some of the details on what I've learned over the years. Here are some Candace grapes that have been working for about 3 weeks now. So I'll show you how I cleaned everything up. First, everything that touches the wine's got to be really clean. I use bleach. It's worked for me. There's a lot of other things you can use. So I've had these grapes fermenting in this pickle jar. I have an air trap on top to make sure that outside yeast doesn't get an opportunity to get in there. Now the yeast that's working in here comes from the actual grape. Before I let this ferment, I had everything clean, just like I'm doing right now. Now I just let it ferment until it doesn't ferment anymore. If you prefer a sweeter wine, you want to catch it before all the fermentation is complete. Now, a lot of people will put in potassium sorbate. Once the wine tastes the way you like it, you put this in there and it slows down the fermentation process. Another way to stop the yeast from continuing the fermentation process, you can heat it up, boil it, and pasteurize it. My old Italian friend wouldn't think of any of these, so I don't either. If I was gonna do one or the other, I would probably try pasteurizing. But for now, it's done fermenting. We'll go ahead and keep the process going here. So now I'm gonna pour all this mash into a colander. Then you've gotta press out all the juice. Now a lot of the juice comes out without pressing it. Now after you get this pure juice out of here, you can actually fill this back up with water, add a little bit of sugar, make wine again. Now it's not gonna be near as good as the first pressing, but rather than throwing it away, you can make this second pressing. Maybe you wanna make cooking wine vinegar out of it. Later in the video, I'll show you how to do that. So as you get the juice all separated, you wanna pour it into a container. Again, anything that touches the wine, you want it sterile. After it goes into the bottle, everything's gonna settle down to the bottom, and then we'll siphon out the good stuff. Now the wine tastes okay with that sediment in there, but you certainly wouldn't wanna serve it to a guest. You want the wine to look clear. Now as you're pouring this, you wanna slow down because all the sediment stays back. You can see all that sediment in there. This is no race, just take your time. If you press it like this, you're not gonna get a lot of juice out of there. Now, if you don't have a wine press, you could just use a juicer. Just make sure that you get everything all cleaned up with bleach. So instead of pressing out the juice, you spin it out. It is amazing when you think you've got all the juice squeezed out, how much more you get. Using a good old fashioned wine press would be pretty cool, but this definitely works. So we'll keep adding the wine to the bottle. Now with the juicer, you'll have to pull the pulp out. Now I'm gonna take all that pulp that's in the machine and I'm gonna put it back into the same container that we fermented the wine in the first time. Now when you let the wine sit, you're gonna start to see everything settle at the bottom of the jar. So just keep pouring it in and letting it sit. While we're letting it settle, we'll go ahead and start getting the next second pressing ready to go. Now the sugar will keep the fermentation process going and the grapes will add some flavor. So we'll just add in some water. So you can see that it's not gonna be as flavorful as the first time, but it definitely works. So we'll let this sit for 20 or 30 days. Now that things are settled out a little bit in the other bottle, we could take a hose and go ahead and siphon off the clear stuff. So you could take a smaller bottle and make sure it's lower than the bigger bottle and go ahead and siphon it into the smaller bottle. Just watch your tube to make sure you don't get into the sediment and put it into your smaller bottle. This method works a lot better than pouring back and forth into glasses. Now there will be some sediment in the smaller bottle as well. So if you want your wine clear, just repeat the process. So you can definitely see that line in there with the solids. And you can see that the smaller bottle has a lot less solids in it. Now it's time to just enjoy a glass of your hard work. Well, I appreciate your time and thanks for watching.